Hey guys, welcome to another exciting tutorial of creation process. And in this video, we'll be preparing this professional logo and we'll understand how we can prepare this kind of similar designs in a very simple and step-by-step process. So to begin with the tutorial, we will first understand this design. So if you see this composition here, you can see that this design comprises of a triangle. The triangle with the thickness, and the triangle has been used and prepared a small piece, and that piece has been repeatedly twice used and placed here, and after that some glossiness has been added. That's all. The second thing is, while preparing any design, you have to decide which art color you're going to use. It is very important to understand your theme and understand your color and keep it a color palette. Keep a color palette of your design. If you're preparing design, don't go to the color palette and search for the colors. Make your color palette before it, place it there, and just make your design and use that colors. That's the thing which I use every day. So let's begin. To begin with the tutorial, we need a triangle. And to make a triangle, we'll go and we'll see which are the two options we can use to make a triangle. We can even use star tool, we can use polygon tool. So let's use polygon tool. And if you click on the blank surface, you get some radius as well as the sides. We can decide how many sides you want. We need three, click OK. And give it some stroke color. So stroke color is black. Let it be, we'll change it later. So let's give some thickness. Before that, let's just scale this part. It's very small, so we need a bigger triangle. This much is OK. Now increase the thickness. With the up arrows and down arrow key, you can decrease the thickness of the triangle or maybe the stroke. So see which how much thickness you want. Once you are happy, just keep it there. And we need a round corner here, so let's select this object, go to a stroke and make it round. By clicking here, you can make the corners round. Now we got the triangle. So second step, we'll make this and convert this into object. So let's expand it and click OK. Now it's object form. Let's tilt this to 90 degree angle. So rotate this by clicking shift and you got perfect 90 degree angle. The next step is we'll prepare a small piece of this. So you can see that this piece has been cut from here. So we need a piece here, and it should be cut by a triangle. So they will duplicate this, Ctrl C, Ctrl F, Ctrl C, Ctrl F, and scale it down a bit and rotate it to an angle and place it there. And for our convenience, we'll just change this black color to something else, like maybe a little blue, any color for our convenience. So we'll just scale this up a little bit and place it properly so that it cuts and it overlaps these corners too. So to see that, Control Y, you can see the outlines. Now place it there properly. If it's going outside, just rotate it inside and scale it down a bit if it's very large. And with the arrow keys, just place it properly. And once you get that, click Ctrl Y to see the color. Now select this and subtract it. So subtract this part and ungroup this and delete the unnecessary part which we don't need. Like this part. Let's change this color. It's getting trouble. So let's apply some gradient here. And we can see the unwanted parts which are available here. We just select that and delete that part. So here we go. Let's apply this blue from here. Now the next step is to duplicate this piece and rotate it up, keep it here. So to do that, we select this part and we need the center of the triangle. And to find the triangle, I'll use a line, and from their endpoints I'll just draw a line which is going through the points of the which is perpendicular to the line here opposite. You can find that by each. You should see that this line should intersect this point, the triangle in between. So just adjust it there. Select that and give it a stroke color. The same way, we'll draw from here to the opposite angle. In the same way, from here and intersecting the part, see that it should intersect this point, so adjust it with your selection tool. And you can find the center point. So once you get that, here's our center point. We'll select this and Control 2 to lock it. Once you locked, it's independent. You can select it now. Now we'll select this part, go to rotate tool and keep the center point here. Now with the alt click with the mouse, with the mouse click and drag and clipping, pressing the alt, you can duplicate it once, place it properly, duplicate it once again by clicking, by keeping it the center here, and duplicate again once and placing it properly. So you got your three pieces here with perfect, with exact measurement. Now we'll remove this part, we don't need this. So Control Alt 2 to unlock the object and delete it. Let's apply the gradient properly. So select this triangle with the gradient tool and the color selected. We'll apply the gradient properly. Next, we'll adjust this gradient colors. Okay, and once you have done that, just play with it a little bit. This one we need yellow, so with the color picker we select this and the gradient tool, we'll apply a proper gradient color again. Maybe again select it. Sometimes it gives some. Eyedropper select. Okay, so here we got. Okay, so the last part, we'll apply the gradient with the eye picker. We'll select the pink color with the gradient tool. Again, select it and apply the gradient color properly. Play with it until you find it correctly. So once you get that, we'll apply some reflection here. So we need this part, two parts here, Control C, Control F, and combine it with using the Pathfinder tool. We'll need a small ellipse which will cut the portion like this, bigger one. We'll keep it here somewhere here and just subtract it, or maybe using the shape builder tool, you can just select this one, make it object and delete this part. Now select this object and apply some transparency gradient here. In the gradient tool, change these colors into white and this one also white, and with the gradient tool just apply it properly. Once you feel that it's fine, you can even increase or decrease the opacity to 90 degrees. Okay, that's all. So here we have prepared. We need one more thing here. We'll just group this, Control G, and increase its length. We need a little long player logo. And once you have done that, we can even add the shadow here. We will make a rectangle, small rectangle here. Remove the fill color, or maybe just fill it with black color. And with the pen tool, subtract, delete one of the anchor point, and with the selection tool, keep it in the center. Now go to effect, blur, Gaussian blur, and blur it out, preview it a little bit more, and click OK. Reduce the transparency to around 50%, and you got your shadow. Place it, arrange with center back, and this is how you can prepare a unique, catchy design or a logo or icon in a very step-by-step procedure, and by understanding its basic shapes and using the same shape again and again, and preparing the whole product. Hope you enjoyed the tutorial. Thank you very much.